Hello, everyone, and welcome to another video slash podcast if you're listening. And today I'm delighted to be joined by one of my cycling heroes, Matti Breschel of EF Education EasyPost now. And of course, he was a former rider riding for Saxo Bank and one of the names in terms of Danish cycling. And great to have you here, Matti. And yeah, first of all, what's it like? Okay, you can see I'm sporting your old kit. But first of all, how's it been for you going as a former pro into becoming a DS, a sports director?
Oh, it's been challenging. Just the fact that you quitting your career after so many years, riding my bike, since I was a kid. And then kind of, you know, jumping out of the circus, I had like a moment where I didn't know what I wanted to do. Didn't know if I was good at anything except for riding my bike. And then JV and Charlie Vigilius offered me a possibility to start working as a DS, and I said yes immediately. And then it was just full on from there. And I didn't have a clue about how it was. I thought I had a clue how it was like to be a DS. But there was so much more that I wasn't aware of. Just working in Excel sheets, PowerPoints, spending most of my time in front of a computer doing logistics and all those things, that was very challenging. And then I had a period where I reckon I felt stress for the first time in my life. It was just too much almost. So I must say the whole lockdown saved me a bit. To at least put, you know, the active career on a distance and just slowly get used to this new life almost. But now I'm super happy. I love my job. And whenever I'm in the car, I feel like everything makes sense, you know. I'm in my right element and I love it.
What's kind of been your highlight so far being a DS for EF?
Oh, I think I have a lot of highlights. I mean, my first grand tour was the Giro d'Italia, where Ruben Guerrero, he won the mountain jersey. And we won a few stages, and I was there with my old teammate, old sports director, Fabrizio Guidi, who taught me a lot. So that was kind of a highlight. And I learned a lot that year, my first year as a DS. When was that? 2020. But whenever a rider wins, I got the feelings on the outside of my clothing, like I'm almost in tears, you know. It means a lot, and it's nice to kind of have the feeling like you're giving back to the sport you love so much.
How does it compare to you riding and you winning? I mean, we spoke about this before starting. I'm still angry at Tohus of what he did at the Worlds. I was screaming at my TV. I so wanted you to win that World Championship. But yeah, how does it compare? Well, we can touch on that. How frustrating was that for you?
No, bloody Norwegians.
Yeah, exactly. Like...
Oh, that still hurt. No, I mean, I don't know. I like the, I have a pretty aggressive side of me towards tactics and how I want to ride the races. I don't know. I think I'm more or less the same. I do much more thinking about tactics now than I did as a rider, where you're just in it. And when I was a rider, I was riding a lot on instinct and, you know, didn't have a plan. Or I mean, I had a plan, but you know, it's cycling. You can't plan anything. So you kind of have to adapt into every different scenario, every different situation. And that's kind of what I'm trying to do also as a sports director. And then you have riders who don't know how to do it. But that's a nice challenge, at least.
Well, you are an incredible, successful rider, and you inspired so many Danish riders. You were part of the Reese team, of course. I think a lot of the riders riding now, as them being on the channel and speaking, what their inspiration was, it was the Saxo Bank team, the CSC team. So for you, is it quite nice to see that not only Mads Pedersen winning the world championships, Jonas Vingegaard, Jakob Fuglsang to some extent, but he was your teammate, but all these young riders doing incredibly well, and Denmark having this kind of golden generation, you would say, because of you guys?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I had some guys coming and saying thanks. When I was a rider, I wasn't aware that these young kids look up to you. You don't really think about it in that way. I mean, you're just riding your bike, but then you have a whole generation looking at you, getting inspired. And yes, you see so many Danes now being on top of the world tour. It's super nice. I don't know if we have more than, 25 world tour riders, so 24 or something. It's crazy.
Yeah, that we don't even know kind of says it.
Yeah. Like it's high quality. And even on the amateur scene, you see guys that, like, they're really big talents, you know. So yeah, it's nice to be part of setting a kind of a high standard.
You guys, as an EF, you have two Danes, and that's the reason why you are where you are right now, the Danish championships with Magnus Kort. So that must be nice as well to have two Danes in the team.
Definitely. I'm super happy, and I would love to have more Danes on EF. But yeah, those two guys is super nice to work with. Quite easy, you know, and still they have things to learn, still things to improve and improve. And if I can just make a little bit of a difference, then everything is worth it. But yeah, I was behind Magnus yesterday in the TT. He was second, 7 seconds behind Matthias Norsgaard, and that was a little bit too close. I still felt it this morning that I was, you know, I had that feeling like, damn it, man, Magnus deserved to win, you know, even though Matthias is a super nice guy. But my riders to win.
Me just having to get used to saying Magnus and not Magnus.
Magnus, yeah.
But anyways, the big, huge elephant, yellow elephant in the room is that the Tour de France is starting in Copenhagen this year. And what's kind of your view on, well, it's amazing for Danish cycling, but, and it's the biggest thing we've kind of had in Copenhagen in cycling terms since the Worlds, which unfortunately you told me you weren't actually there for, unfortunately. But what's your view on kind of the three stages that we have, the one in Copenhagen, Roskilde, to across the Storebælt, and of course the final stage in Vejle, which you're very used to, Vejle, because of the Tour of Denmark, of course, not including Kilsvej, which is really frustrating.
Yeah, yes and no. I mean, it's a potential shit show, to be honest. I mean, I did recon on all of the stages, and I just see like almost 200 wild, crazy bike riders, super nervous, and I expect the worst, to be honest, with the wind and everything, and the Danish roads is not really made for cycling. You have high curbs, and you know, traffic islands and speed bumps. And oh, I hope everybody just make it safe to the line. But yes, I mean, it is nice for Danish cycling. But for sports tractor, I mean, it's just... Oh, man, that's a lot of work.
What's kind of your ambitions this year anyways as a team? Obviously, you want Magnus Cort to win the time trial. He goes into yellow, takes it all the way through Denmark. But what's kind of the goal long-term-wise? You've got Ruben Guerrero and Chavez looking good in the mountain Mont Ventoux challenge. But is that kind of what you guys are going for?
I mean, it's not a secret that we had a lot of positive COVID cases during Tour of Swiss. So right now, we are waiting a little bit to make the final selection because of health reasons, basically. Obviously, we want to have a strong team at the start of first stage. And those guys you mentioned is some of our key riders. I hope to have a lot of success. Ruben just won on Mont Ventoux a couple of weeks ago. Nilsson Paulus, he became fourth in Tour of Swiss, and Magnus is riding really, really well. He finished a hard Giro, and he was second yesterday in the Nationals. So we'll see. The ambitions is high, but there's a lot of good bike riders out there, that's for sure.
And of course, just finishing up here. And one other thing that we've got in the Tour de France this year is that you and your friend, you've made the cycling game, and you're very kindly donated some to us that we're going to be raffling off on the channel. So what's your opinion? What was kind of the inspiration behind this pro cycling quiz game?
Well, to begin with, I hate board games.
Good start.
So the idea started like, let's try and make a board game that me and my friend actually want to play. We love quiz. We started working on that last year. Made, I think, 2,500 questions about World Tour cycling. And I'm really curious to see if people likes it. But I think it's super funny. And it's basically just made on passion and love to cycling.
So that's basically it for this interview / podcast or whatever. Thanks very much, Matti, for joining. And I'm sure we'll see you at some other point, definitely in the Tour de France. So with that, thank you, Matti. And thank you, everyone, for listening. And I will see you around.